Hello, I welcome you on Theater Recap. Today I explain 2014 movie Vampire Academy. We see a girl named Vasilisa at the start of the film. Her entire family was involved in an accident, which deeply disturbs her. Because she has been having nightmares about this incident, which scares her a lot. In the difficult time of Vasilisa, her friend Rose accompanies her. Still now when Vasilisa became scared, Rose came to calm her down. When she comes to know that Vasilisa did not take dinner, she offers her blood to Vasilisa. Now, it is revealed to us that they both are vampires. Rose peeps from her window some mysterious people. They probably come either to kidnap them or to attack them. Because Vasilisa belongs to a royal family and she is the last member of her family. Many people want to kill her. Now Rose wants to take Vasilisa safely far away. But on the way, that people attack Rose and Vasilisa. Rose fights with them. Meanwhile, another man comes. He faints Vasilisa and Rose and sits them in the car and takes them far away. In this scene, we notice that vampires too have different kinds. In which easeful vampires come before all. They called Morwa. Ont the second number damper comes. They are the combination of human and vampire. These vampires work for the protection of peaceful vampires, Morwa. They are called guardian vampires. Now we will call them guardian further. Here we notice that Vasilisa's friend Rose is a guardian vampire. That's why I was taking Vasilisa from here to a faraway safe place. The man who has kidnapped them was also a guardian vampire. His name was Dimitri. He comes here to take them into a vampire academy. Vasilisa could live there safely, but on the way, the third type of vampires attack them. They are the vampires that are evil and only have to spread destruction. The guardians with Dimitri fight with the evil vampire and defeat them. In this way, they safely reach Vasilisa to the academy. The Vampire Academy is a unique world, no principle or the world works here. Vampires around the globe come here to study. As described earlier, that vampires have different kinds, that's why they study separately. Morwa, the peaceful vampires learn magic, whereas, guardians who have to protect Morwa learn to fight. Now, we notice the man Dimitri who had kidnapped Rose and Vasilisa take them to the principal office. Here the principal scolds Rose because she could not perform her duty of protecting Vasilisa. As informed earlier, Vasilisa belongs to a royal family and she is the last member of her family. Her protection was important. The first priority of the academy was the protection of Vasilisa. When the principal was rebuking Rose, an old man appears. He was the friend of Vasilisa's father. He stops the principal to rebuke Rose. But she was quite angry and was about to attack Rose. Dimitri stops her. He also tells that Rose is a special guardian and Rose and Vasilisa have a special bond. Because of this, she could feel the pain of Vasilisa. She has visions of Vasilisa. Actually, if she would be at distance from Rose, she could see her. Dimitri tells that such a bond between guardians and Morwa is hard to find. That is between Rose and Vasilisa. Listening to this, the principal leaves Rose. Getting out of the office of the principal, Vasilisa notices a girl she never likes. Because she always teases her and was still doing this. Now, Vasilisa becomes worried from her exchange of words and goes into a church. There she finds a boy who was like her because he too has no family. We notice about his family, which was converted from peaceful vampires Morwa to dangerous vampires. That's why everyone considers him evil, that he will change into a dangerous vampire. No one likes him because of this and he feels lonely. Here we notice in church that the boy and Vasilisa have a good bonding with each other and they become good friends. Here we watch, Rose takes Vasilisa to the restaurant. The restaurant of vampire was strange, like hospitals. Here humans willingly come to donate blood and everyone was taking blood there. In the Kafa copyright, they meet another girl who is granddaughter of the man whom we watched in the office of the principal. The name of the girl was Natalie. Because Natalie was an innocent girl. That's why the old man requests Rose and Vasilisa to befriend her. In the next scene, we watch all the vampires in a church. They were listening to a priest. Meanwhile, a blast has erupted there. Everyone becomes afraid and comes out. On coming out, they notice under the picture of Vasilisa's parents it was written, "Leave or die." Which means go from there or die. It could be a threat for her to leave, otherwise would be killed. After this incident, the principal of this academy becomes worried and enhanced the security of this academy. Here the guardians take Vasilisa safely to another place. In the next scene, when Vasilisa and Rose were in their rooms. Rose has a vision that she is in trouble. As she gets into the room of Vasilisa finds a dead fox outside her room. Watching this she becomes worried. Now, Rose states to her senior, Dimitri, that she wants to learn to fight to protect Vasilisa. In the next scene, Rose mistakenly tells everyone that Vasilisa takes her blood. Out of which Vasilisa bursts her anger and rebukes her. Here they both have a fight. Vasilisa goes into a church by leaving Rose. Rose tries to find her by the power of her vision. She comes to know that she is in church with a boy. This is the same boy whom we watch at the start of the movie with Vasilisa at church. Now we watch Vasilisa at the hall of the academy where the queen taunts her on leaving the academy. After being worried about these taunts she gets into her room. Here the same warning was written on the wall which was written in church. Now with this the friend of Vasilisa, Rose, and Natalie become worried. Now, Natalie tastes the blood on the wall which was neither of humans nor anything else but morwa vampires. Which was not of a single moroi but of many morwa. Vasilisa thinks that the girl whom she dislikes and who teases her is responsible for all this. Afterward, the reputation of Vasilisa was getting down because everyone knows. She escapes from the academy. Now to clear her position she thinks to use her magic. She thinks to control the minds of everyone so, she could eradicate the bad stuff from their mind. This seems wrong to Rose but Vasilisa doesn't listen to Rose. When Vasilisa doesn't listen to Rose she becomes angry. Rose goes out of the room and outside she watches the same boy. That was with Vasilisa in church. He comes to meet Vasilisa. After watching this, Rose thinks that the boy is the culprit that is instilling strange stuff in her mind. That's why she lies that she doesn't like him and only passing time with him. After this he becomes sad and leaves. Next, Rose has a vision about Vasilisa that she is putting her point of view with magic on others' minds. Meanwhile, Vasilisa comes to Rose and Natalie too comes, she has a laptop in her hand. Natalie tells that this is the laptop of the girl who always teases Vasilisa. It is revealed with her laptop that the brother of Vasilisa has cheated on him. That's why she wants to take revenge on Vasilisa and her family. Now, no one was in her family so, she wants to take revenge on Vasilisa. Now Rose comes to know that the girl who teases Vasilisa and her friends have bandage on their hands. This means that the warnings on the walls were written by them for Vasilisa. Along with they watches the girl meeting with the principal when Rose goes near they stop talking. In the next scene, we watch Vasilisa starts the use of magic for everything which could be harmful. While thinking this Rose reminds her teacher who used magic. One day she disappeared suddenly from the academy. Now, Rose wants to know that what happened to the teacher but it was forbidden to talk about her. Rose decided to find her file from the principal office. To know what has happened with the use of excessive magic. So, she could protect Vasilisa. Now Rose knows from the file that while using magic she goes to black magic, because of this weird things happened with her. Rose became really sad to know. In her vision, she watches that Vasilisa has a nightmare in which her friend Church attacks him. Rose watches this dream with the help of Vision. She becomes worried and goes to that boy. Now, Rose tells him honestly that she has lied to him when he came to her house. That Vasilisa doesn't like him. She tells the that she really likes him. And along with she tells that she is trouble. To save Vasilisa. Rose now takes help from her friend. We notice Vasilisa, Rose and Natalie at a party where Vasilisa uses excessive magic. Rose becomes angry and comes out and Natalie and Vasilisa both follow her. Outside, they notice that someone has killed the cat of Vasilisa. She tries to alive her cat with magic. This time she consumes all of her power in that magic. Because of the magic she has a lot of cuts on her hands. Watching these cuts on her hands. Rose reminds something. She reminds her teacher who once said while doing magic to keep away Vasilisa from here. Because in this academy apart from dangerous vampires. Many other people wants to use her power. The teacher told her that they wanted to use her power too. Because she has plenty of power so, they couldn't control. Because of this she becomes lunatic and they have sent her to Mantle Asylum. It might be the same reason for Rose and Vasilisa run from this academy. Here we notice that the teacher erases all the memory from the mind of Rose after informing. Till the time she needs this. Because the time has come that they need all this. That's why Rose remember all these, now Rose tells all these things to Dimitri. And says that she needs all information about her. She wants all information that Dimitri gives her easily. Now Rose with the help of her teacher collects information about magic. After knowing all she concludes that at mostly, the principal wants to kill Vasilisa. The principal to kill her wants to make her new royal family. Rose was carelessly walking and suddenly entrenches her foot in a dig. She falls down and her foot breaks. When she restores her senses her foot was alright. She knows that this is done by Vasilisa. Now Rose and Vasilisa befriended each other once again. Next we watch Rose, Natalie and Vasilisa at a party. In the party Rose was protecting Vasilisa from the principal. She becomes aware of that the warning was written by principal and the evil girl. But who killed the cat was someone else. When Rose was in the room she has a vision that someone has kidnapped Vasilisa. She goes to Dimitri and tells him that Vasilisa is in trouble and we have to rescue her. When Dimitri and Rose were going Rose again has vision in car. Here she knows that no one else but father of Natalie has kidnapped her. He had kidnapped her to use his magical powers to treat himself. He is secretly doing this because Vasilisa could die. Probably after her death, he could be called uncle of the royal family. That's why they were doing this all. We notice when Rose and Dimitri when come to rescue Vasilisa her friend too was with her. On reaching there, where they have kept Vasilisa, Dimitri fights with the guards. Rose and the friend of Vasilisa go to save her. On the torment of that man, Vasilisa treats him. Because Vasilisa was from the royal family that's why she has extra powers. Because she neither dies nor the dangerous diseases attack her. After that Vasilisa releases herself and runs. When Rose and her friend reach there they know that Vasilisa has already run away. There the old man leaves the dangerous dogs on them and along with he comes there too. He firstly shoots Vasilisa but the bullet was shooted at her friend. When he again shoots Vasilisa, Dimitri the guardian takes his gun. Vasilisa rescues a second time. Now the man orders his dogs to attack them. The dying friend of Vasilisa with his magic kills and burns all the dogs. Now they were saved but the friend of Vasilisa was dying but Vasilisa could not let it happen. She uses her magic to save his life but to save a vampire's life requires a lot of magic. With the excessive use of magic Vasilisa and Rose faint. The happy thing to be was that the friend of Vasilisa was saved too. In the next scene, the old man was in jail. The man was a moroi, but he crossed all the limits of bad vampires. He transforms his own daughter into a dangerous vampire and attacks her on Vasilisa. But Rose rescues her and Natalie fights with Rose by defeating her. She brings her father out of the jail. Here Dimitri enters and kills the old man and Natalie to rescue Rose. In the mid-credit scene, we notice Vasilisa lecturing the vampires of being united in the hall of the academy. In the last scene, we watched the teacher who becomes a lunatic with the excessive use of magic. She far away from the academy beyond the mountains has made her own army. Showing the army of vampires, the movie ends. Please subscribe our channel, thanks for watching.